Do we have an order?
Good evening, Senator Sanders. My name is Tori, and I'm here with the Uniquely You Summit organization. And my question is, the United States has formally apologized for the internment of Japanese Americans during World War II and for subjecting black men to syphilis research during the Tuskegee experiment. But an American president has yet to muster up the courage to formally apologize for the 400 heinous years of rape, death, and inhumanity that occurred during the enslavement of black people in this country that still impacts millions of slave descendants. Senator Sanders, will you, if the next president of the United States, make that necessary and overdue apology?
You want the short answer? Yes. There's nothing that anybody can do to undo the deaths and the misery. How many people we don't even know who died on the way over here from Africa, those ships. Nobody, we cannot do that. But we have got to do everything that we can to wipe the slate clean, acknowledge truth. You know, truth is not always an easy thing. And a lot of things that we have done in this country that are shameful, and we've got to recognize that and own up to it. So the answer is yes.
What is your question for Senator Sanders?
Good afternoon, Senator Sanders. My name is Catherine Hicks. I'm with the Philadelphia Sunday Sun newspaper, which is an African-American publication, and the Pennsylvania State Democratic Black Caucus. And my question is, what is your view on the subject of reparations and the economic impact it could play in the African-American community, given the positive effect it has had in other economic groups?
Well, I think my view is pretty close to President Obama's. And that is, we understand the legacy of slavery. We understand that. And as I mentioned, and as everybody in this room knows, what we're seeing in many African-American communities, outrageously high levels of unemployment, inadequate education, inadequate health care. And I think what we have got to do as a nation is invest in those communities who need that investment the most. And there's legislation introduced by some members of the Black Caucus, which I support, which takes a look at those communities around America which have long-term structural poverty issues, and they become the communities that receive the highest priority for federal funding. In other words, let us make sure that in every way, federal funding goes to those communities who need it the most. And in most cases, they'll be minority communities.